Apple just released the second developer beta of iPadOS, and with it comes a new SMB server connection feature. With iPadOS, we're already able to connect everything from hard drives to flash drives to easily access files and copy them to the local storage. We have a full guide on how to do that, which you can check out by clicking the card above, but for this video, we're going to show you how to wirelessly connect to a hard drive, NAS, or server over an SMB connection. The beauty of this is that if you love using your iPad for editing photos or videos or doing production work, you'll be able to access all the files on your hard drive or server as long as you're connected to the same Wi-Fi connection that your router outputs. Modern Wi-Fi routers allow you to connect storage to them, either by a regular USB connection or with an Ethernet port. The more advanced server storage systems include Ethernet ports for simple connections straight into a router, and they also have applications and instructions on how to connect using SMB. The common person won't have one of these. They'll have a regular hard drive, SSD, or maybe even a flash drive they want to connect to. So let's go through the steps on how to do this. First off, you'll need to access your router settings through a web browser that's connected to your router's Wi-Fi network. If you're not sure how to do this, refer to your router's user manual. Our router tells us to go to this website. We already set it all up and created a password, so we'll just log in. Now here in our dashboard, we see a section for external storage which is empty. So let's go ahead and plug in a simple flash drive into the USB port on the back of the router. Back at the router settings page, our drive now shows up. So let's click Manage Storage. And right here, you can see a MAC access address with SMB right in the beginning of it. Now let's go back to our iPad, go to the Files app, and tap this little edit icon within the Browse tab. Then tap Connect to Server, and type in that SMB address and hit connect. Now you can simply connect as a guest, but if that doesn't work, you can register as a user. Most user accounts will be named admin by default, and the password should be the same password you use to log into router settings. If not, you can read through your router's manual to set up your external storage in account name and password. We already have a large 100 terabyte SMB server set up, and we've logged into it on our iPad. So here it is within the Files app, and as you can see, we now have access to up to 100 terabytes of files we use every day for editing videos and everything else we do. Browsing through all the files is super quick, no lag or load times at all. And here's a video playing. It opens up just fine and plays back fairly smooth, but not perfect since it's over the internet and not straight off a physically connected drive. We can easily tap and hold a file to drag it, and tap on even more files, then open the On My iPad location and drop them right in. Surprisingly, the transfer speed is very quick considering it's downloading the files using Wi-Fi. And there you have it, those files are now on local storage. Even better, let's use Split View to open up the LumaFusion video editor. Now, we can drag and drop files straight from the SMB server into LumaFusion and start editing. This is great because if you make any changes to files on your server on your Mac or computer, it'll instantly be updated on the iPad. And if we didn't have SMB server support, we'd have to transfer files from the server to a flash drive, and then from the flash drive to the iPad. If you haven't watched your iPadOS multitasking guide, you can check it out by clicking over there. And if you enjoyed this video, tap like and hit that circle above to subscribe so you don't miss out on more videos like this one. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.